During drop in water conditions, boys and girls, nothing beats the grab of metal. I'll fight anybody on that one, but let me say, number one are spinners. When you're coho fishing in the fall on dropping water conditions, spinners work so well, it's hard not to use anything else. But let's just talk about the blue foxes we have here. These are probably the number one used spinners in the whole planet. Fours, five blades, you can feel the thump, lots of flash, silver plate, colored bodies, you really can't beat them. If you did nothing else but throw spinners for coho during dropping water, you'll probably catch all the fish you need. Number two would be these little creatures right next to it. I love spoons, as you know, and sometimes the dropping flutter of a spoon will outfish a spinner. Give it a shot. If you have never seen this phenomena, give it a try. Same deal. We're talking silver plate, a little bit of color, but in the clearer water, go to copper. Silver plate when there's color, maybe put some color on it. It's anything you're confident in, but silver plate's the key. When the water's got color, when the water gets clear, go to copper. Dropping and fluttering spoons, casting and retrieving spinners upstream and back to your position, you really can't beat it. And when the water gets low and clear and those fish get potted up next to the wood, guess what, boys and girls? Remember that bite on the drop? It's tough to beat a jig because A, they're inexpensive, B, they work really great. You cannot beat these in clear water. For a clear water presentation, jigs, dropping and twitching jigs, the half ounce, but 3/8 ounce is probably the most popular and easier to cast. They drop at the right speed. These are primarily marabou and bunny bodies, and as all fly fishermen know, these things breathe and move. Coho cannot leave them alone. I'm telling you, man, when the water gets low and clear, try a jig. One thing we really love to do now, we all love the bite, casting plugs, especially if you're on the Snohomish system and on the coast now, has really gotten big in popularity just because of the grab and the wiggle. It's a fun thing to do, a lot of animation, and their coho really strike these things hard. They'll draw fish out of wood, they'll take a bite in every water condition. Casting plugs is fun. The Brad's Wigglers you see here weigh about, half an ounce a piece. Cast well, they wiggle a lot, they're compact, so they cast good, and that's what makes them, people like to use this style of plug, because like the Wiggle Warts and the Brad's Wigglers, the compact cast better, not as much, it doesn't catch as much air, and they just work really well for coho, and the primarily colors, anything in natural tones, like nickel, chartreuse works really well, and metallic pinks and purples. If you can do nothing but those two colors, you'll catch all of them you want. The thing is, make sure you have a good steady hold of the rod, because when they eat these, they eat them good.